Hi everyone, just on to make a quick video here and let you know a couple of things that are happening. Here in Ireland there's an important referendum coming up at the end of May, and it's an equality referendum again, and we will all have to go out and vote. But I just wanted to let you know that it is happening and that it will be coming up, and I will make a further video on it before the voting occurs. It's around the 20th of May, would you believe? I don't even know the exact date. But I do hope that all young people will go out and vote, because so many of them have a vote and don't use it and don't realise how important it is, because it can change things. It can change things for a lot of people. Now, the issue at stake is about equality of marriage. Heterosexual couples here in Ireland, men and women, can get married legally, but gay people and lesbians cannot. They can have a civil partnership, which means that they will go before a registrar and they will have a civil partnership, but it's not actually the same as a marriage now. And I don't know if it's enough for them to have right of property after death and things like that. I'm not quite sure of that, and I must look into that. But they are having a referendum to change the constitution so that they will be allowed to have a marriage, so that if one partner dies, the other, I presume, can inherit, and they will have the same rights as married couples in law. And I don't see any harm in it, because a lot of people say, well, sure, isn't there a civil partnership there at the moment? But I don't think this is enough to safeguard a lot of things that are important. And also, to them, it's not a marriage. And if two people are in love, whether they're men loving men or women loving women or men loving women, and if they want to get married, and if they are committed to a long-term relationship, and if they want to live together for the rest of their lives, I don't see why they should be stopped from having a marriage. It's not going to affect any of us in any way by letting them marry. I mean, it's not going to weaken heterosexual marriages in any way just because gay people can marry. Some people here are arguing about children. What about children? But as it stands in the Irish law, gay couples can adopt and they can have children and rear them as their own, and they often make better parents than heterosexual couples that might be arguing all the time and the children being reared in an unhappy background. But that's already there, so this new amendment to the constitution isn't going to affect the rights of children in any way, because children, a lot of people say it's about children, we're objecting because of the children need a mother and a father. Children just need loving parents who will nurture them and care for them. And loving parents can come in many forms, many sizes. They could be in a wheelchair, they could have special needs, they could be gay, they could be heterosexual, they could be any form or any make of parent. Once it's a loving parent that looks after the child will be fine. It makes no difference whether they're men or women. And anyway, many women have lost their partners, or many men have lost their partners, and children are reared just with a one-sex parent, and it doesn't do them any harm. So how can two of the same sex do any harm? And in old Ireland, years ago, many generations lived in the same house. So you would have had the newly married couple, the mum and dad, and you would have had maybe the father's mother and father also living there. And there would probably have been an uncle or two that wasn't yet married that also lived there. So the new children were brought up with an amount of both male and sometimes female people around them, and they were reared in this sort of a way, and it did no harm. And I think if two people love each other and if they're committed to a relationship, they should be allowed to take that final step and get married and safeguard their future for themselves and their children if they have any children. So that vote will be coming up the end of May, and I'm going to vote yes, because who am I to judge others? Everybody has a right to happiness. So live and let live. It's not going to do me any harm. It's not going to do anybody any harm. It can only do a lot of good. So hopefully the referendum will get passed and everybody will have marriage equality. Now, I hope I haven't got any of the facts wrong. I've just been listening to some TV debates and things like that. I haven't read a lot about it in the newspapers, and to be honest with you, lately there's not a lot about it in the news. Would like to learn more about the details just to make sure I'm not giving out wrong information, but in my opinion, from what I have seen and from what I have heard, this should be passed and it should be allowed. So hopefully it will be, but what it does need is for everybody to go out there and vote. Because so many times we have votes in Ireland and they're important, but people don't bother to go out and vote. And you need to, if you want to be part of this decision, if you want to have some say in it, whether you're going to vote yes or whether you're going to vote no, you need to go out and voice it and write your name on the paper, put your little tick there, and we shall see. I may do another video on it nearer to the election when I have more information and when I might know better what I am supposed to be talking about. But I can't see any harm in it at all. Maybe you can let me know in the comments if there's anything that you think. If you agree with me or if you disagree with me, put it down below. You're welcome to your opinion as much as I am welcome to mine. And I do hope you will practice your opinion by going out there, if you're Irish, and voting. So thanks for listening to my little ramble on marriage equality here in Ireland. I like these debates. I like to think we're a progressive country and a nation that welcomes and embraces all sorts of differences and ready to accept all that is good in life and ready to accept everybody as they are and not insist that they change or not insist that they conform. I suppose it's the real meaning of freedom. And we do live in a democracy. And we have this right, we have this vote, and we're very lucky that we can actually stand up and say what we think. And it's great that we can voice our opinions without being afraid of what others will think, without fear of punishment. So I'm looking forward to the debates, and I'll let you know how it's going. And I will let everybody all over the world that follows me, I'll let you all know about the results. So, what do you think? Should there be marriage equality or not? Bye!